It's neat that that works. Alright, here I am. Mega Man Battle Network by Capcom. I don't have the music on. I'm gonna turn the music on very briefly. Just so we get the title theme. I am going to play through the entire Mega Man Battle Network series. Oh, that might be hella quiet, actually. That might not even be audible. It's quiet. I don't give a fuck. I'm going to be playing this game mute. The reason I like to play Game Boy Advance games mute is that I tend to use a lot of speed up. Just to, like, skip through kind of boring segments. Or, like, segments where not a lot of stuff is happening. That being said, I'm probably not going to be skipping cutscenes or anything like that in this game. I want a playthrough of, like, every Battle Network game. Me playing every Battle Network game to completion. Like, to full completion on YouTube. And it's kind of a big undertaking because there's, like, a million. But if you're going to watch the archives of this... No, none of these games... Okay, yeah, some of these games are kind of bad. I'll talk about that. If you're going to be watching the archive of this some point way down the line, if you're like some guy on YouTube right now in the far-off year of 2017 or some bullshit, I highly advise putting on your own music, maybe? I don't know. Whatever you want to do. Anything that helps people chill and whatever. Anyway, Battle Network is a series that's near and dear to my heart. And unfortunately, in the process of playing all six games... I have to play two of the kind of bad ones, which are 1 and 4. 1 is mostly bad because they hadn't really figured out how anything works. So, like, a lot of features that are standard in all future games don't exist yet. But it's also kind of interesting because it shows you where the series really took off. Battleship data. A lot of people passed on Battle Network. They found out, like, that it wasn't a very traditional Mega Man game at all. And they didn't really touch it, but it's actually an incredible series. Here's me. I am Lan Hikari. Hikari means bright in Japanese. Lan is a pun for, like, you know, computers, Ethernet. I have test answers. That's very Lanish. We learn a lot about this character very quickly. Lan is actually quite a dynamic character over the series. Despite the fact that only, like, 1 and possibly 2 years happens over the course of all six games. Also, there's a frequent soccer theme with Lan that's never, ever brought up. Literally, soccer is never mentioned at any point during the series. But if you explore all the things that are, like, Lan-themed all over all the games, soccer is almost always the go-to. I got an AI navigation program. Mega Man. Mega Man is the Navi of this game, and by Navi I don't mean the Net Navi, which he actually is, but I actually meant Navi the Fairy. He will tell me where things are and where to go. He will also have one of the main functions of the game, which is browsing the internet. I can jack into this computer. This game was really weird the first time I played it, and it's very strange that it opens like this. Ooh. It's too old to jack in. The Battle Network games take place slightly in the future. In the far-off year of 21XX. I forget what the actual year is. Did it already say it? Recover 10. Morning, Mom. There are some slightly futuristic things in every game. How do I eat? Am I just going to leave without eating? Yeah. Mail! No one asked for you. Wait for me. Soon. Why do we always have to walk to school together? Meeting mail for the first time. This game is a little bit like Pokemon. Or a card game. A card game would be a better comparison. In that it's a JRPG where you collect things from opponents. In Pokemon you collect the actual monsters themselves. Well, that was fast. In this game, you collect, in true Mega Man style, the attacks of your opponents. Dex was looking for you. This game is surprisingly an amazing love letter to the Mega Man series, but it takes a little bit of thinking to figure out why. Dr. Yasuo. Madame Yai. Yai is actually only 8 years old, and I don't remember if that's ever acknowledged at any point during the series. We're all a bunch of, I think, fifth graders, right? And Yai skipped a bunch of grades in order to be on the same class as everyone else. But this is like never acknowledged. It's like never acknowledged that Yai is a child. That she's like literally like 8, whereas everyone else is supposed to be like 12. Maybe not 12. Like 10, I don't know. For real? No way. Yesterday, our home oven started spitting fire. That might be important later. So that WWW is actually pronounced World 3, and apparently they have a plan to control the net. Let's actually inquire. They make viruses to control the net, then they'll control everything, schools, the army. Controlling the internet equals controlling the army. What dystopian future is this? I'm not gonna go examining everything in the game, or like trying really hard to examine everything in the game, but it's worth noting that you do find stuff by like examining things. I thought we were supposed to study him, not the other way around. I don't know the alternate universe plot line of this series. I know it's like, I think it's after every other Mega Man game chronologically, except I mean obviously no, obviously it's before Star Force, and I guess it's probably before Legends. I don't know where Legend. I think Le Legends is almost certainly dead last in the grand scheme of Mega Man plot. Note that I sit next to male. This is important. Just kidding, it's not, but it'll be true every single game. We are fifth graders. Carve graffiti into the desk. I love guts, man. Where does Yai sit? That seems a little big for a little Yai. Mega Man against Guts Man. It's Guts Man! Da-da! Dex is introduced in the first game as a bully. That will quickly be abandoned. Look at this generic ass kid. Look at my hot teacher. We're gonna learn how to fight viruses. You can really play the battle networks in any order. I tentatively recommend playing 6 after you've played all the other ones because it's kind of a love letter to all the other ones. I just said love letter for like this game for the series, but you know. Six kind of wraps. Six is the last game, and it kind of wraps things up because they knew they wouldn't be able to make another one. Metal. I jacked into the internet. The animation changes every single game. I'm on the internet now. So the green navvies, this is only said like one or two times, but the green and pink navvies are actually generic navvies. Like, most people get. What's like a good comparison? I feel like there's real world products where an easy comparison can be drawn. Net navvies are like license plates, okay? I mean, they're not in any way like license plates, but imagine, like, most people just get a license plate, you know? Just like a cheap one. That's just like, you know, assigned to them and they're all kind of the same. I mean, none of no two license plates are the same, but they all, you know, kind of like just churned out. It's just a bunch of them. They're all generic. But then you can pay extra and have good programming and have a net navvy that looks really unique and has unique abilities that make it cool looking or good at virus busting. These are the people with the vanity license plates. Mega Man is a unique net navvy. Most of the people in this class have generic ones, but me and all my friends have unique ones. That's probably why we're friends. Occasionally, there's an important character with a generic net navvy. And actually, one of the games lets you fight generic net navvies, which is kind of strange. None of this is like ever acknowledged or described at any point. Yeah, phones, maybe. Oh, I forgot that chips you can't select aren't dimmed in the first game. There are so many little things that are different and shitty in the first game. Alright, here's the battle system. She's explaining it, but I'm just gonna be doing it the entire game. Look at these kids, look at these words. This actually gets explained at the beginning of every game. And they have to keep on thinking of more and more ways to, like, sneak it in. That, like, Land wouldn't already know it. Only the first game has 15 chips available at start. Or rather, 15 chips here. Miss Mari. So you can pick any pair of chip, any number of chips as long as they're the same. And then you can also pick, all chips have a code, and you can pick chips with the same code. So like this is a steel S and a wide sword S, so I can pick both of them at the same time. But I can't add on like a something A. And if I have like a wide sword A, a wide sword S, and a steel S, I can either take both wide swords or the steel and the S wide sword, but I can't take like all three or anything like that. Nuked. I also have a buster. I can shoot them with my buster. The charge takes a fu- Oh, I can't even charge it. I forgot. Charging is not an inherent property in the first game. Oh, look, it gave me another steel and another wide sword. Bonk. Swords attack very close and do lots of damage. Steel lets you take enemies' spaces. Look at all these words. Oh, no, lesson on adding? I thought it was a lesson on adding. What the hell? It's just a pop quiz? Every other game it's a lesson on adding. I can't, it won't even let me add these. That's fucking stupid. These things take turns moving. They can only move straight up or straight down. And then when they're in the same line as you, they'll attack you. I have their AI memorized because they're in every fucking game. Donk. That was a super short school day. Hi, yi. No, I don't care about anything. What's the big deal? Oh, God. All right. Boss, Gutsman. I got two swords. Swords are pretty good against Gutsman. Gutsman will occasionally run up to your face and punch you. A guts punch, if you will. But I tried to dodge on reaction, but I was really shitty. It's alright because the reward for this battle is actually fixed. That's the final component of this game that sort of makes it the most interesting. Ooh. One Gutsman, please. Oh, no? Can I fight him again? Oh, he wants to upgrade first. Wow, I thought you got a Gutsman chip. Maybe you're supposed to fight him later. Oh yeah, email. World 3 crime is on the rise. Crossgun C. Power up. He doesn't even give it to me. Look at all these words. Mega Man Baffle Network. I like that. There's so many people to talk to. I guess I'll talk to some of them. Look at this kid! What's he doing? What's he doing? They're playing hide and seek. It's weird that there's cars. Cars aren't in Battle Network 2 through 6. It's weird that this one has them. You can only keep 30 chips in your folder. In fact, you have to have 30 chips in your folder. If you try and have less, the game won't let you. So I was just kind of pulling chips out during those battles. They're automatically given to you. But you can actually modify which chips are in your folder, which ones will be given to you. I only have the crossgun and a recover 10, which is pretty pitiful right now. But we'll start talking pretty soon about how you get more. Why does this bitch want to know about? Whoa, hold on, she just told me. That was it. That's the only line of dialogue you ever get about who she is. I'm still only 8 years old, I skipped a grade. My family has some money, and I know a lot about PETs. PET stands for personal terminal. Personal terminal. Yeah, he's rich. I've never known if this is a man or a woman. Mel's house is pink because she's a girl. My house is blue because I'm a boy. Metro line. Here's Dex's house. It's locked. It's a kid. The first game, like, tries to make you think that all of these houses are inhabited. There will be no acknowledgement of these houses. They'll just be here in all the sequels. But this game has, like, people standing outside them and shit, acting like other people actually live in this town. My doghouse. It's actually a security system. I don't own a dog. And I can jack into it. You can jack into it in every single game. Ah, the internet. A prog. I'm a doghouse type security system program. Found that the presence of a doghouse reduces the chance of a burglary. I'm almost like a watchdog for this home. I love this prog. He'll be in other games too. Those things are called Mr. Progs, aka programs. They are not navvies. I'll actually take this and then just manually kill them. Shouldn't have put that guy there. That was an inconvenient place to put him. It's actually okay. So this is the first time I'm gonna be graded. Bonk. I got a triple delete, which gives you a pretty nice grade. At the same time, I took a really long time to kill them and moved a lot. Busting level 10 is one below the max. I got a Shockwave K for that. Every time you kill an enemy, if you're good, you can get their chip. Every enemy has one and occasionally two chips they can drop. Every time I run into an enemy, I'm gonna try really hard to get their chip. There's actually one enemy who, by some glitch in this game, I think doesn't drop a chip at all, which is really inconvenient. You actually cannot get an S rank against a single virus, unless it's a Navi. Like, it's just impossible. Kind of, it's not really an oversight. I don't know why they designed it like that. Against a single enemy, you can only get a busting rank of up to 9. You need double deletes or triple deletes in order to get higher. Fortunately, enemies always appear in groups. Looks like I've gotten everything here. This will be a good busting rank. I don't have to move. I kill them both quite quickly, and I get a double delete. It's probably an S. Shockwave C. See how that's different from Shockwave K? Based on how good your busting rank is, you can get different codes. The high-level codes won't necessarily be better. Just depends on what codes you'd rather have. Variety is good. Oven's exploding. This character is actually very prolific in this series. We'll see him a lot. I think he's in 3 games? Or maybe 4. I think 3. I think he's in 1, 3, and 4. I don't think he's in 2. My name is Lan. Lan Hikari. Hikari Lan, if you will. My net navi is named Mega Man. It's actually named Mega Man.exe. I like him in this game. He has a vague ninja design. Oh, the internet in the first game is so bad. I forgot how bad the internet was. My name is Glide. He has to introduce himself to me. I'm gonna do my best to, like, figure out how this place works. I forgot how bad. Okay, so the first game is full of, like, little things. Here's escape. The first game doesn't. I forgot about this! You can't run from enemies in the first game. You have to use the chip that allows you to run from enemies. In all future games, you can actually run from enemies as an inherent choice. Like, just by hitting L on that little screen. But in the first game, fights are, like, mandatory. Okay, so these green things are like the random drops of being on the internet. Every map will have several places where they can appear, and then a couple places where they do appear, like two every single time. And every time you, like, jack off the internet and jack on the internet again, jack out and jack in, as the game says. Excuse me, jack off. These things respawn their locations, so, like, you can, you know, I could go and find this several times. The Birdman jokes. The first game has an oversight. I saved over a file, what the hell? I might have already saved before. The first game has an oversight that you can save in front of these things and then open them repeatedly. So, like, I can just restart the game and then open it again. And this time I got 500 Zenny. So you can, like, scum them for, like, things that you want. I got a Met Guard A. I'm gonna try and get 1,000 because I think. No, I think you can get 2,000 from these. Up to 2,000. It might only be 500. I'll try a few times just to see what we can get. But this is like. This is one of two giant oversights in the first game that makes the game completely stupid. Is that you can just grind any chest. I'm calling these things chests. Let's go ahead and take a 500. Next time we see one. Met Guard is kind of good too. I'll take a Met Guard. Access. I don't have the address, so I have no idea where it goes. The internet is not divided into sections in the first game, so every single map looks like every other map, which makes the internet really annoying to navigate. In addition to that, there aren't that many shortcuts to get around the internet quickly. So I'm gonna be lost probably a lot, even though I played this game somewhat recently. Alright, what we got? Two swords. That's useless. I haven't showed off adding yet. Oh yeah, I forgot! Adding was probably available in that one mission. I probably just didn't like try. I forgot how adding worked in this game. So in later games, well, I'll just talk about it in this game. In this game, when you pick chips, you can no longer add. If you deliberately don't pick any chips, you can select add, and then you'll have no chips for 8 seconds, which is how long it takes between menus. And then you'll have access to 10 at once, but only for that turn. So you'll be able to pick out like more chips. Add is okay in this game, and it's changed quite a lot in future games. All right, here's the other one. They'll both contain the same thing on different maps. I mean, on the same map. 500 Zennies is what I wanted. There was a 100% chance that would have the same drops as the other one I had. I'm moving quite a lot. Taking damage also lowers your busting rank. Killing enemies within 7 seconds, I think. Ooh, I just missed it. 7 seconds for viruses. 30 seconds for enemy navvies. Ooh, this is good. I could get an S rank on a cannon. I missed it. Maybe that damage didn't knock me down. Oh, it just knocked me down. Damn it, I would have really liked that. I should have moved. I didn't want to move because I figured I could shoot those too fast enough, but I forgot how much recoil was on those things. Those chips are only in the first three games and then they go away. Here's a single virus. Oh yeah, using a bunch of chips can lower your busting rank. Bunch of stuff like that. See how I killed him super fast with not that many chips and not that much movement, and I still got busting rank 9. Net Merchant. He has an HP memory and a power up and a hammer. He sells a Cannon C. I could already have a Cannon C if I wasn't a dumb fuck. I might want that hammer eventually. I'll probably want that spreader. I definitely want all power ups and HP memories. Getting money in this game isn't that hard because of that chest spamming glitch. Ooh, there's the dash attack enemy. I might be able to kill both these enemies at once. I don't remember if dash attack can go through other enemies in this game. Mine is fine. Give me dash, damn it. That's still okay. Theoretically, no. Theoretically, this is the same universe as regular MM. Theoretically, all MM games are same universe, which is really crazy to suggest. I can't think of any two MM games that expressly negate the possibility of, like, one expressly negates the possibility of another. Later, haters. I'm pretty sure there is some elaborate timeline that people have concocted. I don't like these chips at all. The great thing about this game is the amazing level of customization in the battles. That being said, when you just start off, your deck is extremely, extremely stiff. Makes it difficult to really, like, do anything meaningful in these fights. So I won't be doing any sort of grinding for chips or anything like that. Probably ever, but definitely not until I hello. Until I have a better deck. Spreader Eye. So that's this chip that was for sale. So I now know that I don't have to buy that because I'm not going to need more than one. It is kind of a good chip, so I might get more than one anyway. There's no way I can kill these things quickly. I'm probably not going to get a chip from this. I'm just going to take the opportunity to escape. You always get a drop when you win a battle. Sometimes the drop is money. It's usually a very small amount of money if you did a bad job. You need at least a busing level of 6 in order to get a chip. This game is good. Recover 30, that's pretty nice. I should have save scummed that. Should have seen what it could be. But recover 30 is already something I don't think I had. Alright, I got a double delete, but it's still gonna take kind of a long time to kill the other one. And a lot of chips and a lot of movement, so. Yeah, 10 seconds. A single one. I mean, I guess I'll kill it. I really need to kill some of the stupid chips from my deck, but I don't have any better things to put in yet. The most important thing right now is just getting a lot of money. This is a really stupid homepage. Fucking giant spiral. Alright, dash attack is actually an enemy I really need to kill a lot of. I'll have better opportunities to kill a lot of them later, though. I can't miss this. Don't fuck up. Yeah. Okay. Give me a chip. Damn it. I want a dash attack. I, like, need that enemy. This is Battle Network 1, yes. Alright, we got another chance. This is a notoriously difficult weapon to hit these things with. Okay, got one. Hit-da-da-da. Okay. I can just use three shotguns. It's a bit more reliable than a sword. It's a lot of chips, though. Ugh, it wouldn't let me shoot two. Alright, there we go. It's a lot of recovery on that. No dash attack. I don't think it's that hard to get that one. It is somewhat probability based. Die. Oh, you got me. I mean, I don't want to open it right now. But, like, just relate some of it to us. You have to get off the internet wherever you came onto the internet from. That will occasionally be referenced. I just want to be on this map until I get a dash attack, though, even though I'll probably get a bunch more dash attacks in future. I can do this. I have to do 20 damage to this thing using only my Buster, which is going to be a bit tedious. And then I can just shotgun. Okay, it went up first. Damn it, that means it's going down right now. I got it once. Damn, this is stupid. Double delete. That's probably gonna be an 8. Alright. Got him! Dash attack B. That's the one I wanted, actually. I'll get to why at some point later. You can just jack off the internet anytime. Jack out the internet, damn it. I'm gonna be making that mistake so much. Eek. Let's go. Oh shit. I heard about this. This is that thing where your oven spits flames. I guess I'll help her. What should we do? A virus or a bug or something. The first game begins so innocently. Let's talk to these progs. You can't see the viruses, they just suddenly attack. Gotta find the oven control. those progs are not viruses. And there is a thawing section of the oven that's appropriate. Battle routine set. Execute. Oh god. I wonder if I'll do the double team version of Battle Network 5 when we eventually get to that. Money. I probably have a decent number of, like, cannons that I can swap in here. What's a useless chip? The mini bombs don't do me a lot of favors. I'll have more fun with a bunch more cannons. There are fewer rules in the first game about what you can have and what you can't have in your deck. So, for example, I have a fuck ton of cannons already. I've actually got 7. And now 8. X panel is really useless. Shockwave is okay. Recover 10s are pretty bad. Crossgun is just fine. I don't have any more good chips to put in. I'd rather have recover 10A than recover 10L. Alright, first modification of the deck. So what's this thing? It's, purple is fixed in this game. I forgot about that. Subchips don't exist yet. I don't know if purple's fixed or it just means special or what. I don't remember what purple means, to be honest. Almost no antivirus features. He beeped in sadness. Yeah, in later games it's no more than 4 chips of the same type. But in this game it's, I think, 10. Because, like, they hadn't ironed that out yet. There are so many rules that don't exist yet. Which makes this game really interesting to replay. This is a 60. Gonna send this thing straight to hell. Well, didn't remember how fast it traveled, so I didn't want to get right in front of it. The beep in sorrow. Oh no! The program is no longer functioning. That's the fucking saddest thing I've read today. You have someone type an F for that program. This is actually a really awkward configuration. There's a Met Guard. It's kind of rare to get from those guys. They give you Shockwave, too. Sword. That's alright. We're getting a lot of B chips. Dash attack! This chip is pretty cool. Pretty cool chip. Hits everything in a row. It counts as a double kill if you get two enemies in close enough proximity. Right, this area doesn't look lit up. 7 fires. That's a very specific limit. So you have 7, and you can extinguish exactly 7. But if you extinguish all 7, then you have to come back and then fires realign. This game is actually probably the worst Battle Network. Or 4, depending on who you ask. I personally think 4 is much worse. But like, nearly every other Battle Network is better. Oof. I will say for the first game that it had much more classic bosses than the sequels, because the first game was taking bosses from like the early Mega Man games, and the later games take bosses from later bosses of the early Mega Man games. Eek. He just went boom. How do you know? And why is he keeping in contact with the person he attacked? And why is he revealing his plan? What the actual fuck? That guy works for World 3. Mega Man isn't responding. Here it is. Water gun. There is somewhat of a parallel between the real world and the internet world. So doing certain things in the real world and doing certain things in the internet. Anyone ever watch Code Lyoko? I'm alright. Thanks, Lan. Occasionally a navvy and a operator, Lan's the operator, can become disconnected. This is a catastrophic thing. 200 zennies. I actually want to keep exploring. Monk. It'd be really cool if I got a crossgun as like my next chip. That would be like really swell. Damn it, I got a shotgun. That's still okay. Wily's actually in a lot of the games, spoiler alert. Wily's actually present for like almost the whole series. In fact, he's only not, he's kind of, I think he actually makes an appearance in every single game, but he's not the focus for a couple. But surprise, surprise, Wily is the villain in a Mega Man game, which is pretty cool, I admit. He is a classic villain. This is somewhat an awkward configuration. I'll get a double delete out of this, this is fine. I don't even, there isn't even a chip I care about from these guys anyway. Doesn't matter how it turns out. I'll take every shockwave the game gives me. So I don't think I actually need, I don't think there's any paths that are opened up in this first area from using that ice cube, ice block. Kind of funny, you can shoot faster if you're moving between shots when you're like absolutely as far away as possible from the opponent. Yeah, I went all the way back. Look at this single Metar. Remember how I said enemies couldn't appear in singles? I lied. This is Battle Network 1, no rules exist yet. I have to be really careful about the fires I'm willing to extinguish. I should have spammed that to see what it could be. Two cannons is more valuable than a shotgun. But what I'm going to do is get this guy's HP down. And then kill him with the shotgun. Foresight is a good thing. Destroying one of these top ones seems to be the least. Let's try save stating and see what we get. Oh god, that like freaked out my entire monitor. Is everything still visible? Okay, actually looks good still. Anyway. 500, 500, 500. Alright, I guess save stating. I guess I have to manually save the game and restart. I will occasionally use emulator features. I'm not gonna say I won't, but I'm not gonna use emulator features to cheese anything. I'm only gonna use it to like save time. Alright, that appears to just be 500 Zenny. Nothing more to it. Little bumped. I guess I can kill all three of these guys with a dash attack. Oh shit, I allowed myself to get attacked. I forgot how fast speed was. Bonk. Speed kicks me to 9 times normal play speed. This seems harmless in the long run. Hello. Alright, so the boss is there. And over here is nothing. The burner! I forgot this enemy was in this game. He'll automatically pick a new row every single time you move to the row that he's in. You can use pause scumming in order to figure out which row he's going to. That allows you to cheese him. Pause scumming can actually be used to cheese almost every single enemy in the game. I won't be doing it that much. In fact, I probably won't be doing it at all. I did it right there just to demonstrate that it's possible. It's pretty confusing. It's kind of like I've played a lot of games that are like really confusing, but then when you actually know the rules are really cool. See, I'm shooting faster by going back and forth between them. A nice big cannon. I guess I'll just kill those two manually. Oh, is that how cannons worked in this game? I forgot. Hold on, check this out. Yeah. If you move towards the cannon, it actually dodges the shot. That's so stupid. It just fires a shot on the panel you're standing on. In all future games, if you move forward, the cannon will still shoot you because it fires an invisible shot very quickly across the entire row. You can't move forward and back, you have to move left and right to dodge. So, we have a boss here. I'm gonna save before I fight him, even though there's a I'm probably not gonna die. and his drop is fixed. It's just money. Every boss just gives you money. It's the same amount regardless of your busting rank. So there's no incentive to do well for a boss. You just have to live. Me and Mr. Match. He just says the name of his operator. And the operator already revealed that he works for World 3. It's so stupid. Fireman, let's burn. This is a pretty rad redesign of Fireman, to be honest. In fact, in general, the Battlework redesigns are killer. Probably the best example is Plant Man from Battlework 3. Compare Plant Man from Mega Man series to Plant Man.exe, and it's night and day. Plant Man had probably the stupidest design and goes to being one of the coolest. I guess I'll take two cannons. I don't remember how this guy moves. He moves pretty quickly. And then he fires a row. For a while. I can probably interrupt that attack, or any attack he does. Yeah, the fireman helmet is nice. He seems hard to attack while moving, and if I attack him before he attacks, then I interrupt him, so it seems to be that that would be the good strat in this fight. Just take it nice and slow, stand far away. A lot of bosses have attacks they only use when they get below a certain threshold of health. Again, the amount that I'm shooting for is take no damage and beat him in less than 30 seconds, although it does not matter at all. I can kill him with a sword, if I'm lucky. I just need him to stand somewhat close to me. So that went pretty well. I probably got right about 30 seconds, 40. I got 1,000 zenny for that. At least I finished my mission. I probably shouldn't have told you that. Why did my oven have the key to taking over the internet? I don't know if we'll ever learn that. I think this plot is just stupid. The plots are occasionally really good and occasionally really bad. The story is a roller coaster in this series. It's entertaining even when it's bad. Yeah, it's 4, 5, and 6 that do that system, Ferris. I'll never control the net, not if I can help it. Just a little bite. I appreciate that joke. I can jack back in. So I can check green and explore without the trouble of fires. This enemy configuration is really annoying. There's nothing in the entire first. Oh no, there's green battle data. Oh god, I'm gonna get an S rank on these guys. Oh shit, it's the bottom one that moves first. Alright, cool. Still an S rank. 200. That's more than the usual 100, but it's not a cool chip. A cool chip with a cool chip code. That's what I wanted. I see now that I get absolutely nothing for taking an unusual route down here. In fact, there's no green mystery data. I guess I'll just do a bunch of damage to these other ones and then kill them with a cross. Oh god. This is stupid. This might still net me it's not gonna net me an S rank anyway. But I can probably still get like an 8 or a 9. Cannon B. I don't remember the actual pluses to get S ranks. I don't remember how it definitively works. Alright, I really want this burner guy. If nothing else, this is probably one of very few places I can get him. So I'm gonna do my best to get his chip. That being said, I think I've already failed this attempt. I think this is a C rank. Or not a C. What I call it, a C, 6 rank. 7. It's gonna be a little difficult to get him. I don't have an efficient way of doing 80 damage. Two cannons might get me his chip. Might not. I'll save scum this encounter. Not this one, but like, finding that enemy. I didn't mention this yet, but my HP is actually restored to full between each fight. This is the only game that does that in the series. No matter every single time I do a battle, my HP automatically goes back up to full when it ends. I can't do anything with this. My best hope is to add and then dodge and then pray. Pray that I get an area grab. That thing vaguely tracks you. I did not get an area grab. I'll give it one more go. He can't even hit me from where he is. I got the area grab. And he won't naturally move either. Bonk. Got nothing from that. Took too long. Oh yeah, what was I saying? I was gonna scum. Let's scum this encounter. I'm gonna get some move in, and then I'm gonna save state, and then I'm gonna grind for that burner guy. Save everyone some time and effort. There won't be as much grinding for chips as it sounds like there might be. It's actually really easy to get chips from most enemies. I just don't have a very good deck yet. There he is. And this is a pretty good loadout. Let's see if we can do it. Pause buffering. Oh shit, I missed him. Fortunately, I made a save state at the start of the fight. This is me at my lowest. Okay, that's good. Aw, oh, damn it. I'll give it one more go. And by one more, I mean several. I knew he was gonna go there. Kapow. Yes, thank God. Fire Tower F. Alright, I'm done here. There's no green mystery data for me. I guess it's all permanent. I don't remember if blue mystery data exists in this game. Dog food. Dog bowl. Dog no. It might be dog chow or something, I don't know. Did I explore this? I think there was a chip there. Mega Man is recommending that I hit the sack. Every Mega Man game is divided into days. Battle Hour game. I just finished day one. They're not consecutive days. But they. A lot of significant things change between each day. This character is in. I think he's in 5 of the 6 games. He's prolific. This is so fast, this text. I'm not even speeding it up. Any new mail? Student crime is on the rise. I called your name for you in homeroom, so you owe me one. Homeroom in an elementary school. I guess Japan is different. Check your mail again. Get a third one? No, it's just the exact same ones that I just had read to me. Can't go to the teacher's lounge. This room, a lot of these rooms will be cut out in later games. Like in later, I think in Battle Network, like 3, as soon as you enter the school, you're automatically in your own classroom. Like that's how much of this is cut out. It's just implied you walk through all here by yourself. A lot of these maps are just later implied. It's kind of interesting. The medicine hall had a recover 50G in it. It's important to check these things. Nothing is being displayed. Prevention first. Perform a virus check once a week. I don't think any of those computers have anything special. The first grade class. I don't think there's anything down here for me yet. Library. I don't remember what's in here. Escape Age is pretty good. I like went straight to that as though I remembered that that would be there. But I didn't. This is the kind of reason I'm gonna be using speed, and this is the reason that like the music sounds completely awful if it's on. Is if I just want to scan a bunch of things at once. Anyway. Sneaking into my classroom. I sit in the front. How the fuck did I sneak into a seat in the front? I can't even imagine that. I'm like a professional sneaking into classrooms, and this is just not possible. Mr. Higsby. Haha, snort. I swear that Higsby is like a Japanese archetype. What a short day of class. Oh, that's actually a good line. used to write on blackboards with this chalk stuff, and then you have to wipe it with a big eraser. Yucky. Why is that gross? Literally, why is that gross? Why is the concept of an eraser gross? Oh, who cares? Why can I say that? Why can I be so mean to my friends? I guess I'll listen to her story. Three cannon selected, and all three chips flashed and changed into a rare chip. She's actually lying because the chip that they turn into is not actually a chip. Oh, I still can't fight Guts, man. Sure is hard remembering these chip codes. Remember the order and good will come. All these little hints. I already know everything there is to know, though. Eight? Chalk? I've heard several people say that the consistency of chalk makes it seem delicious to them. Like they just want to eat chalk if not for the taste. And Pez is good because it allows them to eat chalk. Or like Smarties or whatever. American Smarties. His little pose when he checks in. The first game seems to imply that everyone has a little pose when they jack in. We will now announce the real goal of our. Dude, it's Wily. They're taking control of the military net. The only cure for this world is deletion. Me and Gutsman will stop them. Dex is the self-professed best net battler in the class. Of course, it's actually me. What's this arm motion? I suppose it's vaguely implied that virus busting to LAN is pretty much like playing a Game Boy, like pretty much what the player is doing. LAN doesn't control Mega Man. Mega Man is like an autonomous thing. Do you have a backup? Yeah. That is the one line that explains how when a Navi is deleted, the Navi goes away forever, but you can have backups to the Navi. But for whatever reason, LAN literally never has a backup of Mega Man. I got a chip for Roll. That's my first Navi chip. I'll actually put it in just to show it off. Navi chips are not unique in this game. In later games, it'll be a kind of mega chip. I don't need this for cover 10. I could make room for some more shockwaves too. Shockwaves are pretty good. What can I kill? Shotguns are less good than cross guns. Met guard. I don't remember if that has a reflect attack in this game or not. I could put the fire tower in. I mean, that's gonna be kind of cool. I'll put it in just for the hell of it, and I'll just put this to anything that's A. Steal A, that's fine. I really need more chips, though. Hello, sir. So I'm actually gonna try and get 100% in this game. I mentioned that once. Every game has different requirements of 100%. Some of them are actually impossible without link cable stuff, and I'll probably use cheats to just access the link cable stuff. I hope that's chill with everyone. I hope it's chill to cheat to get link cable content. Just 'cause I can't do it on my own, not on an emulator. Hopefully this little guy will just jump into the row that the cannon's on. That would be convenient. Damn it. There's no justice in the world. Come on, you little bastard. It's two out of, okay. Two out of eight. Oh, I got his chip. Quake 1H. That's actually a really important chip, but it's not a very good code for that chip. But there's a chip, there's a. It's a good chip. put it like that. God, I got two, so I don't have to be precise or anything. I need to be more precise than that. It'd be cool if these two lined up. Good enough. It's interesting that they crash down on a panel, but if you destroy them before they come up from the panel isn't cracked. It's like when it crashes down, it should actually destroy the panel. Now I know how locks work. Oh. Do you want to go to the lock? Oh. I'm just going to be unhelpful to every single person who tries to give me advice. Alright, come down, come down, come down, come down. Cool. I can't get them like this. Bonk. Pretty good. It's like S rank. No, not quite. Shockwave K. That's another one. Can't have too many of those. I do not remember where I'm going right now. This feels like the correct way. Never have chosen 5A. Hang on, I'll go check. Is it 9? What do you know? I'm gonna go double check this area because I feel like I missed a secret here. Yeah, I did. The little ghost guy! Actually, this is two really annoying enemies. Steel makes the little ghost guy really easy. But I want the ability to, that little ghost guy is actually a pain in the ass. Alright, that's really good. That was really good. I couldn't have asked for anything better than that. Got Invis 1. That little ghost guy, it's hard to get his chip. It's pretty easy if you have a sword. Sword's good against him. Also, that was Blue Mystery Data. Blue Mystery Data obviously exists. I don't remember what makes it different, though. Blue Mystery Data is one time in later games. It's just like a fixed item. You get it, and then it's gone. Oh, for some reason I thought that would kill him. I think dash attack is 60 in later games, and later 90. But in this game it's only 50. It's kind of weak. Quake 1H. Quake basically functions like a mini-bomb in this game. Nothing over here. I'd really like that guy's chip, but he's kind of uncooperative. Which way are you going first? Okay. Oh, little bomb. Got him. I think I've got pretty much every single enemy's chip. It would be really swell. That ghost guy. Oh, fuck. Okay, it's fine. Took some damage. Still got the invis. Invis is a pretty good chip. It makes you invulnerable for a little period. Unfortunately, the codes make it kind of hard to use with other chips, or else it would be super useful. You're the more annoying enemy, so you die. The closer you are to an enemy, the faster you can shoot them. It's because there's a bullet limit. How surprisingly accurate to the Mega Man series, is what I was going to say. I'll just shoot him to death, it'll be faster, with this horrible landscape. Yes, if I was moving back and forth, I should have been. I wasn't. If I was moving back and forth, I would have killed him faster. I would have shot faster. Hello there. I cannon I. That's like a cannon, but better. Ugh, this is not that good. It's really hard to shoot this guy because he teleports as soon as you get in the same row as him. He's shy. So you have to just, like, move and shoot in, like, the same frame. Invis 1L. That's probably a more common chip code. Ugh, the enemies in this area are just kind of annoying. Fucking annoying-ass creature. Alright, that's okay. All of this is going kind of well. How does Fire Tower... How does this work? Alright, it does the same attack pattern that the enemy has. And I think if I move up and down, the pillar follows me up and down. It doesn't track enemies, it tracks me. So I think you can steer it to some degree. Ugh, I hate these things. They're really not hard. Just wait for them to disappear and then use a shockwave. Could have done it better. It's really interesting. That did 15 damage. Almost everything operates by tens in this series. Number of volumes of history of the world. I think that there are 15. Every time I open one of those doors, I open a door in the real world. Not working. So I'm slowly unlocking more areas to explore. You can learn a lot about ants with an ant farm. Thanks, Lan. Spreader J, that's what I'm looking for. Oh, I can jack in here. Mega Man's not in his pet, though. Rattle, rattle. Next panel 1B. I can't even imagine a game that's Battle Network-like. Battle Network is so unique. The only game that's even remotely Battle Network-like is Star Force. I didn't like Star Force as much, but I didn't actually get into it. But after I finish the series, I'll probably also attempt to finish the Star Force series. I heard 3 is actually a good game, and 1 is like Battle Network 1. What am I trying to find? History of the World? 30. How am I communicating with Mega Man this far away? I mean, I know, like, modern technology, postmodern technology. But that's a feature not present in later games. Mega Man can't just talk to Lan from wherever. I do not like this configuration. I'm out of here. I don't need that guy's chip. Let's just try anything. Too low. Second digit verification failure. You have a limited number of guesses. Oh, it was 91. It'll reset if you take too many. Hello, sir. Fuck these horrible creatures. Jump to the same row, goddammit. Wow. That went pretty well. Never take the intended. What the fuck? There's two doors. Which one's the intended door? Yeah, I don't want to fight these things. Number of doors in this school. Is that 15? I seem to recall a 15. How the fuck am I? No. Oh, that was it. Wow, I remembered. Spreader H, that's pretty good. I'm glad I got that. This is a very bad combo. It's not very bad, but like, fuck, these enemies are annoying. Especially when they won't go anywhere near each other. That's not what I wanted, you little doofus. That's not what I meant by anywhere near each other. Look! I couldn't move backwards. Getting hurt, like, basically doesn't affect me at all. Just lowers my busting rank. Too low. Too high. Too high. Too low. Too high. Hello? You can jack into that blackboard. Maybe I'll do that later, you dumb fuck. HP memory. Okay, that's my first encounter with an HP memory. Or rather, they were in the shop that one time, but now I, this is my first formal encounter with one. Get in the middle. Get in the middle. Cannon D. I thought you got Cannon C from an S rank. What the fuck? Surprised. Yeah, this is the beginning of Battle Network 1. I just began this endeavor. This Battle Network endeavor. Oh, I got roll. I'm surprised. I don't remember if it automatically defaults to like the end on average. There might be some shuffling to keep it so it's rare. Here's roll. She'll automatically attack the closest enemy. Do 60 damage to them. and then heal me. I forget how much he heals. It might be 60. Anyway, I found an HP memory that permanently increases my HP by 20. There are exactly enough HP memories in every single game to get your HP to 1,000. Damn it. Thought I was being all swag. Ugh. It's never easy. Here's that back and forward movement I was talking about. I can shoot him faster. By moving. It's like an oversight. It's a bug. I don't remember if it's present in later games. Interestingly, you may have noticed, you guys, that every single chip I have, for the most part, is based on an enemy attack. I mean, steel isn't. They're not all, but most of them are. These enemies are oftentimes not in future games, but the chip will still be in future games, and the chip will still have that enemy on it. Not taking cards does literally nothing for you. There is no positive. Ta-ta. He failed to shoot there. That's weird. Maybe it's because I wasn't on any of my panels, so he tried to shoot me, but his tracking didn't know what to do. My best guess. Hello, Mr. Prague. I don't know what an AV room is. Oh, the hand enemy. I forgot he was here. That enemy is really annoying. He places a bomb on your side of the field and then, quote, laughs. Honestly, this is probably the best way to go about it. I could kill him faster with the sword, but he places the bomb so quickly that it's kind of hard to get him with the sword before the bomb is placed on you. If the bomb is placed on you, it does less damage than if the bomb explodes. But both of them damage you, so both of them you want to avoid. I don't remember if this game does it, but whoa. Stuck in a trap. In later games, at least, it'll tell you the names of the enemies whenever you start a battle. Hello. Follow her, be deleted. This guy's into it. First graders. Don't forget the beauty of a flower. You can't eat seeds from Latin Glories. Try sunflower seeds. That's good advice. Aye aye. That statue is in a later game. Some kind of larvae. Dude, the guppies are floating belly up. That's messed up. Kids learn about death. Medics. Oh. Maybe that guy's involved in, Is it this one? It's a frozen computer. I restarted it. Maybe that guy's involved in everything that's happening today. Maybe. I really hate these things, and there's three of them. Statistically, two of them should line up. Gonna make this easy or hard. Quick one A. I want to know the... Oh, I just got another one. I want to know the names of those things. I think they're called flappies. The hands, no name is shown. If they both put bombs at the same time, then I maybe could have used a wide sword to kill them both in the same... Aw, damn it. And a wide sword, I could have just stood in the middle. I wouldn't have even needed to react. And they went fucking in different directions. It's not too late. I can still just double delete them. I might be slightly desynced now. Alright, that's still good. Give me a chip. Yes. Time bomb 1J. Too low. Too low. Too high. How did I pick such weird numbers? Ugh, 71. No! I only changed one digit. God damn it. Making me jump through hoops. I was one away from the solution. They are called Flappies, yes. Flappy is a really cute name for that thing. There's no human way these things can have something I want. Huh. And I don't even really need anything from these guys. That'd been really cool if I got the double delete. These things shoot slightly faster than cannons. I can customize my deck, but I've already put all the best chips I have in it. I mean, not all the best, but like most of the best. I don't really care about these things' chips. I'm retarded. Fortunately, I got a double delete for that. Oh shit, I think there's a boss over there. I have like a couple new things I can put in. This Cannon C is kind of nice. Quake, I don't really care about. Spreader is kind of cool, but I don't know. I like to keep a relatively same. I find having a bunch of chips of the same code is more useful than having ID card. Than having a bunch of really good chips. I'm a first grader. Who asked? Oh hey, it's Miss Mari. She looks like she's being tied up. I'm not gonna lie. I saw fan art of this scene. And when I say fan art, I don't mean like that normal ass kind of fan art. I mean like lewd fan art. I got an HP memory. I didn't search for it. I think it was posted on like 4chan or something. But I've seen things involving Miss Mari being tied up. Suffer for me. Why is that an option? All right, boss time. All right, I have to guess again. This sure is fun. Ooh, my second digit is correct though. That's exciting. That was pretty fast. Oh, it just takes me straight to the boss, huh? That's not fair. It's not really cool. It's kind of annoying. My new World 3 salary, I could buy lots of rare chips. Alright, I guess I'll hit this guy with cannons. I don't remember his movement pattern either. I think he stands relatively still. Ooh, this is kind of fun. He sends three balls at you, and they'll have different amounts of health. So you have to rapidly pick which one is the smallest. This is unhelpful. Swords won't do anything for me in this fight. I should have made more of an attempt to get a good deck. I think he has another attack involving dice that he'll eventually start pulling out once his health gets low enough. These swords are useless. I'm picking two swords to get two new slots instead of one. Steel would be okay. Also completely correct in remembering that this guy is somewhat motionless. He actually doesn't move at all. Interesting boss, I suppose. Oh, there's a time bomb. He can summon time bombs. I guess the dice attack is in later games. Technically speaking, even though that does 10 more damage than other things I can do, there's the die. Alright, I can destroy it in time even with my bussing level of 0. Yeah, because I have more cannons in my deck, I'm statistically likely to pull cannons. So I shouldn't have used the cannon, I should have used something weaker just so I could pull two cannons at once. Save me time in the long run. Thinking about the mathematics of the battle system in this game is important. Battle system's actually quite complex. Die. And there's a lot of room for creativity. You wouldn't believe how good a deck can be in each game. And they get better and better at balancing the different options you have as the games go on. The die do the number shown times 10 in damage. Die. The dice. Let's see your rare chips now. This room will not exist at any sequel. Bleep wee. I think if I touch that computer, not jack into it, but just touch it, I get an HP memory. I think that's the one I always forget. I fixed the server too soon. I kind of want to go onto the internet, actually. The net is kind of like a dungeon. That's rad. That's a rad comparison. So there's a bunch of places I can jack into. That one I already explored. There's a bunch of kids now I think I can talk to, but I don't want to talk to them yet. I don't think anything is one time. I think I can just find these kids later on and still get the offers. There's a map of Japan on the screen. Learning about Japan. It's funny because Japan is not actually. Oh, it's just different parts of the level. Japan is not actually in this game. Where do we live? I forget. Does anyone a Battle Network fanatic? I think it's Natopia, right? Natopia is Japan, and then there's another country across the ocean that's America called Electopia. Oh, I'm using an emulator feature that speeds up the game. It unlimits the frame rate. Yeah, none of this is anything interesting or new. Hello. Dash G. That guy wants dash G. This class is learning about chickens. I think this kid. Yeah. 30 Met Guard A. This is the only way to get this chip. That kid will be there the entire game, so I'll have plenty of time to do it, but holy fuck. 30 Met Guard A's. It's kind of a lot. I'll do it though. Sure. That's a terrible trade. I don't even care about her tip. Or her shotgun K. I already got the item that was in here. You don't. There's not that much filler in this game. Wow, I can't even go in. Fucking bitch. You can also skip cutscenes and stuff. Ooh. Pretty much everything tells you when you can jack in. Occasionally something won't tell you, but you still can. There's some extremely cryptic things. Whoa, what's that? That's the Thunder guy, and a slightly advanced version of the Metar. all the game's content is can be called filler, but that doesn't mean it's not fun. But I know that's the point you're trying to make. Remobit. I don't think that enemy is in any of the other games. He might be in Battlework 2. He's definitely not in 3 through 6. I don't remember if these guys have a new chip. I'm pretty sure they do. See how they have slightly upgraded attack patterns? They now guard themselves while they're not attacking. They also move faster and do more damage. Every now and then they pop up, though. I don't know why. Damn it. That was, like, the worst possible. I could have just gotten them all in the line. They'd all die. That was so stupid. I could have killed them all. All right. Let's test out this theory of killing them all. No. Fuck. Oh, God. I'm fucking this up bad. There we go. Cool. Sonic Wave. All right, I got that chip first try. I got an HP memory. I actually cannot charge my gun. But I will eventually be able to. Since this is Mega Man and all that. I'm on feed duty. They just have rabbits. That's nice. Bronze statue of the principal. It was a gift from a mysterious group at the school opening. Don't thought I'll go straight home. That's very Japanese. I can't explain why. Can I go into Yai's house? Oh, sick. I like how she has not quite a Pikachu on the ground. I like how she literally has a doll of Data. And it calls it a popular toy. It's Data. It's fucking Data. It won't let me jack in. No, this is not Mega Man. This is Len Hikari. He is an operator. He's also a fifth grader. Alright, that's how to get to Yai's internet. Beautiful telephone with a jack-in port and a very creepy doll. Mega Man is not a cyborg, he is an android. A cyborg is a person with robot add-ons. An android is a robot in the imitation of a person. Wow, that hit it twice. I guess the Mega Man from Legends is probably a cyborg. Ooh, the sword enemy. This guy gives you longsword. It's also a pitch to fight. Oh, fuck! I forgot that it was a king sword in this game. Jesus, that goes so far. I don't remember if they steal spaces. I don't think they do. Oh, yeah, they do. Motherfucker. Mega Man is not kind of like Robocop. Mega Man is just a robot. He's a robot built by a scientist. Hello. I guess I'll try and get longsword from that guy, but it's going to be a bitch because they're hard to kill. I would prefer to keep them in the same row. Mega Man and Battlework being the father's interpretation of a dead son's persona or an actual son's consciousness. That's disturbingly close to something that's factually true, but also incredibly wrong. But that is a major spoiler of this game. And now it's just out there. I actually do have a Fire Wave F. And I traded it for a Dino Wave R. That's a pretty good trade. Dino Wave is the even higher level than Sonic Wave. It would be rude to open someone else's refrigerator. Don't tell me what to do, game. I can jack into Male's piano, if you know what I mean. It's alright, you were, like, wrong enough that it's not a spoiler. But, like, no one should care about spoilers. Game is more than 10 years old. It's at that point where it doesn't matter. Alright, wait for him to appear, then move down and swing my sword. Aw, damn it. I was a little early. I was way early, actually. It's elaborated more each game. I think 2 has the most elaboration. It's still true, but it's rarely acknowledged in 4 and 6, 4 through 6. But it's acknowledged frequently in 1 through 3, or it's acknowledged frequently in 2 and 3. Or rather, it's almost never acknowledged, but it's true. I got at mail. So now if I use that on the internet, I can come to that place whenever I want. It's like a rabbit. What's this thing? It's like the rabbit's butt. I understand. That's so Japanese. When is it that you can come in here and mail's changing? I forgot about that. In the first game, if you come into this room at a particular point in the game, mail is getting dressed. And you get like a cutscene where she freaks out. Or not a cutscene, but like she freaks out and tells you to leave. Legends did the same thing, actually. I'm looting through Mail's trash while she's not home. She has a Surfbot doll. A Kobun, if you will. Hello, Mr. Prog. Put me down now, things like that. That's so sad. He wants to be put down. I think Legends 2 had like 3 nude scenes, didn't it? There was a bunch of nudity in Legends 2. You just see Sarah naked. Sarah's just naked. That freaked me out. This is like female nudity in a Mega Man game. I was like, what the fuck? And she's like a child too. Thanks, Japan. HP memory. Collecting those. I don't know if I'm gonna try and get every HP memory in every game. I guess I'll try, but like I don't know if I'm gonna like I don't know if I'll care if I miss one. Those two are the same code, that's cool, I just did that like automatically. Damn it, I bumped him. I think you saw Sarah's ass. You didn't see like frontal, I don't think. Or like I think you saw partial frontal. But you definitely saw her butt. Fucking little girl. Little brown girl, naked butt. Is that okay? Is that okay to have in a video game? I didn't think so. A GameCube. The latest in game machines. Not anymore, baby. Maybe once. Legends 2 was a pretty killer game. I haven't replayed it since the first time I played it, though. But I replay Legends 1 all the time. It's weird. It's weird that that's how I do it. I feel like 1 is more self-contained, which makes me more willing to go back to it. I feel like 2 has like a bunch of shit that like scares me into going back to it. I get intimidated. At Dex, all right. So now I just unlocked shortcuts to these areas. Yeah, I kind of know what you're talking. That's kind of my opinion too. I think I had more fun playing too, and there are also things about it that I think are like better from a gameplay design point of view. But I still prefer to replay one. And I think that has a lot to do with the self-containedness, though. Be sure to turn on the lights and don't sit too close to the TV. What was the last one? Playing for a long time, be sure to rest every hour. That's good advice that no one follows. He had a Surfbot, Matt. All little Mega Man references. I'm supposed to be going down to Psylab, but I think I have a lot of money. So I'm gonna go buy some power-ups. Make Mega Man stronger.